What's up, guys? It is I, once again, Yusuf Al Sened. And guys, I was planning to do this review sometime at night because it's the most time I feel at peace and content doing my reviews. But I wanted to make this video as soon as possible. And right now it's morning, as you can tell, but the movie I want to review today is going to be one of my all-time favorites, and a movie that's very obscure, very strange and bizarre as they come, but it's also a really amazing, beautiful story, and that movie is Andrzej Żuławski's 1981 horror-slash-psychological drama, Possession, starring Isabella Gianni and Sam Neill. And Isabella Gianni is an actress I'm very fond of. She's one of my all-time favorites. And this movie right here is Andrzej Żuławski's own personal story and fantasy. I mean, this movie is heavily inspired by his breakup or his divorce with his wife, and how he wrote this movie with the idea that it's just one of those stories that you will really feel disturbed by, or one of those stories that will shock you, or it's gonna like get a reaction out of you for sure, and it's gonna provoke you. And this movie, Possession, guys, now I don't want to give too much away in terms of the plot, but to sum it out real quick, the basic story is about a man named Mark who has just come back from a mission given to him by the British government. He returns home to his wife and child, his wife being Anna, played by Isabella Gianni, and his son being Bob. And Anna has been very stressed and worried for Mark when he will be coming back. And as soon as he does come back, Mark learns that Anna has been having an affair with another man. That man, which he learns through Anna's friend Margie, is Heinrich, a native of Germany, which is where both of them are settling in. And Anna has been having this affair because she's been so worried and so lost without Mark. She's longing for her husband to come back to her, but he never did because of his mission for the government and the fact that he's a very busy man. And that does not excuse Mark for being, well, basically a jerk. And if you watch the movie, guys, which I highly recommend you do, but would cover it with the utmost care, because this movie is just all out there. And Mark and Anna have their flaws to them, a lot of flaws. And what's so interesting is that as the movie goes on, and how these two are going back and forth with whether they love each other or not, and how Mark is obsessed as hell with wanting Anna to come back to him, and how Anna refuses to choose between her affair with this man Heinrich and her life with her son. She wants her son, but at the same time, Mark is almost blackmailing to keep custody of Bob if that means he'll come back to her, and he has to choose between her lover or her family, essentially Mark and her son. And this is a story that's so much a war between these two couples or former couple, and it's just a very stressful kind of film where you see these characters going back and forth, they're battling each other out, and as their anger and hatred for each other grows and grows, the film starts to get even crazier and weirder. Trust me, guys, every performance in the movie is over the top as can be, and there's a purpose for that. I mean, Andrzej Żuławski wanted to tell this a very domestic kind of drama in a very surreal way that's almost a fantasy, especially the things that occur in the film. Things that are very demonic, very akin to the supernatural, and it's a story that is really, it's a very provocative story, and yet it's a story that will always keep you engaged from beginning to end. And Let's talk about Heinrich. Guys, I love this man Heinrich. Now, a lot of the moments in the movie will get like, will not only get a reaction out of you, but it will make you laugh hard. Trust me guys, I was laughing throughout at how frantic and over the top the performances are. But Heinrich stole the show for me. I mean, this guy is all out there. He does things like with his hand and these gestures. He talks in a very philosophical way because he's very intelligent. Very demanding, and he's the kind of person like Mark who demands obedience and loyalty from Anna, and I can clearly see why Anna's losing her mind with these two men who are fighting for her. And it's just one of those conflict that really gets you in, and it's like a soap opera but on steroids. And I love this character Heinrich, and how compared to Mark and Anna, he has the most common sense and is the most rational. And you also have Margie. I mean, Margie is like the best friend of Anna, obviously, and she does take care of their child Bob. And guys, there's two other characters in the movie. I won't give anything away because it's a huge spoiler, but that is how the story goes on. It goes from a marriage domestic conflict or battle between these two, Anna and Mark, and it starts to sink deeper and deeper into hell itself. It's almost like these two and their hatred for each other is fueling the end to come, and it's just so amazing, guys. And I don't want to say anything about the second out of two characters in the movie. That's a huge surprise, but the special effects in the movie is just so good, guys. It's so good. For the time in 1981, it's so good how they made this movie at a very small budget, and yet they managed to make every character in the film look so organic, and everything in the film, I use the word thing as loosely as possible, because the things in this movie is just so crazy, guys. I mean, my mind is still boggled by what I just saw this morning. I was actually watching this movie this morning, and it still stuck with me. And Anza Jaworski has told a very personal story, but told it in a way that really gets you inside his head and what he's thinking. His personal fantasies of how he envisions the perfect wife who's obedient, loving, and always there for him, and it always listens to what he wants. I mean, at time, guys, I hated Mark and Heinrich, but at the same time, I can't help but sympathize with Anna. I recognize that she's also at fault. Nothing is black and white, but I just can't help but sympathize with her and her situation, because I've encountered people who are demanding and very, very like authoritative in how they demand every obedience from you and loyalty and stuff. But there's one scene, guys, in particular that will remain in your mind for years to come. Trust me, this scene involves Isabella Gianni in a train station. It's a very long scene. I think from 6 to 10 minutes long. It is the most talked about scene of this film. And you will not go out this movie without that scene sticking in your mind. And Isabella Gianni was actually scarred by the film. She had to take years off because of how this is a movie that really stuck with her. It's a movie that scarred her, especially the performance she gave and how frantic she was. Everyone in the movie is frantic and over the top, but she sold it so well. And guys, Isabella Gianni is one of the greatest actresses out there because of performances like this. That and Nosferatu, the vampire by Werner Herzog, the Brandt sisters with Emily Brandt and her sisters, and she also was in the story of Adele Etch, which was the story of Adele Hugo, Victor Hugo's daughter, and her obsession with love and finding her lover. This is the kind of performance that Isabella Ajani sinks her teeth into, and she is so good, guys, as is Sam Neill. Now, for a big actor, or at least an actor like Sam Neill, who would go on to be a big actor in movies like Jurassic Park and so on, he is so good in this movie, guys. I hated him, I laughed at him, I kind of sympathized with him at some moments, but he was a powerhouse in this film, and Heinrich was so entertaining to watch. He really was. And guys, once again, you have to go into this movie knowing what this film has or what's about. And if you go into it knowing what to expect, you will have a blast with it. Trust me. It's not so disturbing, like it's, oh my god, gory and stuff, and it's very sad and depressing. No, it manages to be everything. Have dark humor. It has comedy. It has like a drama, serious drama about domestic abuse and domestic conflict between these two, Mark and Anna. It has a lot of elements of horror and a psychological story about loneliness, obsession, and it's just one of those films that is everything, and it has a very heavy topic it's dealing with, especially as the movie reaches its conclusion or its finale, and it's a masterpiece, guys. I mean, I can't find any flaw with this movie. Everything is made according to how Andrzej Jaworski wants to tell his story, and it is brilliant, guys. It is absolutely brilliant, and I highly recommend you all watch it. And guys, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoy my video. If you want to see more from me, then please like, comment, subscribe, and check out my gaming channel where I do Let's Play videos and other gaming content. Until next time, guys, peace out, take care. Adios, amigos, au revoir, and sayonara.